Welcome back into the world of cross-dressing stories. Now, please consider subscribing and check out my Patreon for more exclusive goodies. Jordan had always felt a subtle dissonance with his body, a quiet unease that lingered in the background of his daily life. Now, in his early 20s, he had built a modestly successful career as a graphic designer, channeling his creative energies into vibrant layouts and logos that belied the discomfort he felt within himself. It wasn't just about appearance, it was deeper, a sense that something didn't quite align. His recent diagnosis of gynecomastia brought these feelings into sharp relief. Jordan learned that the development of breast tissue, which he had first noticed as a teenager and anxiously dismissed as a quirk of puberty, was actually a medical condition. It caused him not only physical discomfort, but also emotional distress, especially in social settings and even more so in intimate moments. The slight bulges under his shirts became a source of insecurity that he could no longer ignore. Sitting in the small, sterile doctor's office, Jordan listened as his doctor explained that wearing a bra could provide the physical support he needed. The words were practical, clinical even, but they unleashed a torrent of emotions in Jordan. Apprehension crept through him at the thought of buying and wearing a bra, a garment he had never envisioned for himself. Yet, there was also a whisper of relief at the prospect of alleviating some of his discomfort, and unexpectedly, a spark of curiosity flickered within him. As the doctor discussed the different types of support garments, Jordan's mind raced. The recommendation opened a door he had always seen but never dared to approach. It wasn't just about the physical aspect of wearing a bra. It was what it symbolized and the exploration it invited. Could this be a path to understanding the deeper discord he felt with his own identity? The doctor handed him a list of recommended stores and brands, his voice a calm constant in the whirl of Jordan's thoughts. Leaving the office, Jordan felt the weight of the decision ahead. To embrace the doctor's advice was to step into uncharted territory, not just medically, but personally. His walk back to his apartment was slower than usual, each step heavy with potential change. The city around him buzzed with its usual indifference, but for Jordan, everything felt different, charged with the possibility of discovering a part of himself he had yet to meet. As he approached his building, the apprehension mingled with a budding sense of excitement. This was more than a medical remedy. It was a step toward aligning his outer reality with an inner truth that was only beginning to make itself known. Jordan's heart thumped audibly as he paused in front of the lingerie store. The warm glow spilling out onto the sidewalk beckoned him, yet his feet felt rooted to the spot. The window displayed an array of beautiful, delicate garments, the likes of which he had never imagined wearing. Gathering his courage, Jordan pushed open the door, the gentle chime announcing his entrance. Inside, the store was a sanctuary of soft lighting and elegant displays, walls lined with intricate laces and silks that whispered of hidden worlds. His nervousness was palpable, a sharp contrast to the serene ambiance of the shop. The scent of lavender and fabric softener filled the air, soothing yet unfamiliar. As he hesitantly browsed through the racks, his fingers brushed against the soft fabrics, each touch sending a ripple of conflicting emotions through him. It wasn't long before Mia, a sales associate, approached him. She had a gentle smile that reached her eyes, instantly warming Jordan's tense demeanor. "How can I help you today?" she asked with a tone that mixed professionalism with a touch of genuine concern. Jordan's voice faltered slightly as he explained his situation. Mia listened intently, nodding with a compassion that eased some of his anxiety. "You've come to the right place," she reassured him, her voice a soft anchor in his sea of discomfort. "Let's find something that makes you feel comfortable and supported." Mia guided him towards a more secluded part of the store, where the bras were more functional yet retained an aesthetic grace. She explained the different styles and materials, her knowledge deep and her approach non-judgmental. Jordan felt his initial resistance wane, replaced by a burgeoning curiosity about each piece's purpose and design. As Mia measured him for the right fit, her professionalism made the process feel less intrusive and more like a rite of passage. Jordan was struck by the strange intimacy of the moment, standing there while Mia expertly determined his size, her hands deft and reassuring. When she brought a few bras for him to try, He was surprised at the variety. Some were plain and purely functional, others surprisingly elegant. In the fitting room, Jordan faced himself in the mirror with a mix of trepidation and anticipation. With each garment he tried, something within him shifted. The bras were not merely items of necessity, they were symbols of a burgeoning acceptance of his body. As he fastened the hooks of a softly padded bra that Mia had recommended, he noted not just the physical support it offered, but also the emotional relief. The mirror reflected back a version of himself that was both foreign and deeply familiar. The discomfort of his gynecomastia was there, but so was something new, a sense of rightness in his own skin. Mia's occasional knocks on the door, asking if everything was okay, grounded his experience in a comforting normalcy. When he stepped out to show Mia, her smile was encouraging. "How does that feel?" she asked, and Jordan found himself returning her smile with genuine relief. "It feels good," he admitted, his own voice surprising him with its firmness and clarity. Leaving the store later with a discreet bag in hand, Jordan felt a mixture of emotions wash over him. There was still fear, yes, but also a sense of empowerment. For the first time in a long while, he felt aligned, his external experiences beginning to mirror the complex, beautiful reality of his inner life. This was not just a bra fitting, it was the fitting of a new identity, one that he was slowly, surely learning to embrace. After the bra fitting, Jordan walked home with a lighter step, his mind buzzing with a mix of relief and newfound confidence. The snug but comfortable embrace of the bra beneath his shirt was a constant, gentle reminder of the shift taking place within him. It was more than just physical support. It felt like a piece of armor, shielding him from the discomfort and the emotional weight he had carried for so long. In the privacy of his apartment, Jordan stood before his mirror, allowing himself a moment to truly see his reflection. The bra, hidden beneath his clothes, subtly altered his silhouette, smoothing the lines of his chest into a form he hadn't realized could bring him peace. For the first time in a long while, he looked at himself without the sharp sting of self-critique. Instead, there was curiosity about his body, his identity, and how the two intertwined. This initial acceptance crackled through him like electricity, sparking a desire to explore further. Jordan's next steps took him online, where he started researching and eventually purchasing various pieces of feminine clothing. Each parcel that arrived was like a gift to himself, a promise of discovery. Dresses, skirts, and blouses in soft fabrics and gentle colors filled his wardrobe, each item holding potential for revelation. The exploration of cross-dressing became a deeply personal journey. Each evening after work, Jordan would try on different outfits, experimenting with styles and colors that he felt drawn to. The soft swish of a skirt, the snug embrace of a fitted blouse, each added sensory detail helped peel back layers of confusion, revealing clearer glimpses of the person he might truly be. Emotional growth threaded through these sessions of self-exploration. With each garment he tried, Jordan not only saw, but felt different parts of himself come alive. Some items resonated deeply, bringing a surge of joy and recognition, while others were gently set aside, part of the process, but not the outcome. In the mirror, he began to see not just Jordan, the graphic designer with a talent for visuals, but Jordan, whose identity was as multifaceted as the patterns and textures he now adorned himself with. The real transformation occurred in these quiet, solitary moments. Seeing himself dressed in a way that felt right, his reflection smiling back at him with eyes bright and clear. These were moments of profound connection with his inner self, as if each layer of fabric he added helped to unveil deeper truths about who he was and who he might become. As he embraced cross-dressing more openly, his apartment became a sanctuary where he could express and accept himself fully. It wasn't just about the clothes, it was about the freedom they offered him from predefined roles and expectations. They allowed him to explore a spectrum of identity that was more colorful and complex than he had ever allowed himself to imagine. This journey of self-discovery did not erase his fears or the challenges he knew lay ahead, but it equipped him with a profound sense of self-acceptance. The emotional armor he had built, piece by piece, garment by garment, fortified him with confidence and a quiet determination. Jordan knew there was more to explore, more to understand, and more to accept. But for the first time, he felt ready to face whatever came next with an open heart and an open mind, anchored in the truth of his own experience. Bolstered by his journey of self-discovery, Jordan knew the next step was perhaps the most daunting yet, opening up to his family. The thought of sharing his true self, a self that was still taking shape before his very eyes, brought a mix of fear and resolve. His family had always been a source of support, but this was uncharted territory, layered with potential misunderstandings and deep-seated biases. One cool evening, Jordan invited his family over for dinner. The familiar sounds of preparation, the clatter of dishes, the sizzle of food, were underscored by the heavy beat of his anxious heart. As his family gathered around the dinner table, the aroma of home-cooked food filled the air, a veneer of normalcy that belied the significance of the evening. With everyone settled, Jordan took a deep breath, the words he had rehearsed tumbling out in a less practiced manner than he'd hoped. He explained his condition first, gynecomastia, which seemed the simplest part. It was the next part, his decision to embrace wearing women's clothing as a form of self-expression and comfort, that made his voice shake. The room fell silent, his words hanging in the air like delicate glass ready to shatter. His parents exchanged glances, their initial reactions a complex tapestry of confusion, concern, and an attempt to understand. His mother's face showed soft worry, her eyes flickering with questions. His father's posture stiffened, the lines of his face hardening not with anger, but with a father's protective concern. Jordan's sister, ever the empathetic one, reached across the table, her hands squeezing his in a silent show of support. The questions began, tentative at first. His mother asked if he was sure, if this was what he really wanted, her voice a mix of maternal concern and love. His father, struggling to bridge the gap between his expectations and the reality presented, asked about the implications of his choices, his voice tinged with worry about the world's harsh judgments. Jordan answered as best he could, his responses a blend of honesty and reassurance. As dinner progressed, the initial shock gave way to a deeper dialogue. Jordan shared more about his experiences, the emotional relief he felt, and how his exploration of identity had led to a happier, more fulfilled life. It wasn't a smooth conversation. There were pauses filled with heavy breaths, moments of visible struggle on his parents' faces, and tears from his sister, moved by his vulnerability. By the end of the evening, a tentative acceptance hung in the air. It wasn't perfect. There were still many layers of acceptance and understanding to peel back. But his family promised to try, to learn, and to support him. His mother's final words that night, whispered as she hugged him goodbye, echoed with sincerity, "We love you, no matter what." Leaving the table that night, Jordan felt a weight lift from his shoulders. The path ahead would require patience and courage from all of them, but the foundation of their love and commitment to understanding remained unshaken. As he cleaned up the dishes, a sense of peace settled over him. The peace of being seen and, despite the challenges, accepted. The story of Jordan's journey culminates in a small, warmly lit community center where he attends his first support group meeting for crossdressers. The room is filled with a variety of individuals, each with their own stories of discovery, struggle, and acceptance. As he steps into the room, the nervousness Jordan feels is tempered by the welcoming smiles and nods of understanding from those around him. The atmosphere is one of solidarity and shared experience, a stark contrast to the isolation he had often felt. As the meeting begins, Jordan listens intently to the stories shared by others. Each narrative echoes parts of his own journey, fears of rejection, the joy of self-acceptance, and the ongoing challenges of living authentically in a world that often misunderstands. Inspired by the courage of his peers, Jordan decides to share his own story. With each word, his voice grows stronger, more confident. He talks about his medical condition, the initial fear of buying and wearing a bra, and how these experiences open the door to a deeper exploration of his identity. The group listens with rapt attention, their nods and soft words of encouragement bolstering Jordan's resolve. Sharing his story in such an affirming environment transforms his narrative from one of personal struggle to one of communal triumph. The experience reinforces not just his own acceptance, but the acceptance he finds in this new community. As the meeting draws to a close, Jordan feels a profound connection with those around him. He exchanges contact information with several members, eager to build the friendships that had begun to form. Walking home, the cool night air feels invigorating, filled with possibilities. Back in the quiet of his apartment, Jordan reflects on his journey. He sits by his window, looking out at the city as it sleeps, the lights a distant, twinkling panorama. He thinks about the unexpected path that led him here. A path marked by challenges, but also by incredible moments of clarity and joy. He is grateful for the support he has received, not just from the new friends he made at the meeting, but from his family, whose love and acceptance have proven pivotal. Jordan acknowledges the importance of self-support through his journey. The moments of self-doubt and fear were numerous, but so were the moments of self-care and courage. Each step he took towards embracing his true self helped to build a resilience and self-love that he had not known before. As he writes in his journal, Jordan captures his thoughts and feelings, documenting this milestone in his life. He writes about the importance of community, of finding others who share similar paths, and how these connections can transform personal trials into shared victories. With each word, he commits to continuing his journey of self-exploration, armed with a deeper understanding of himself and bolstered by the support of those around him. Jordan closes his journal, a sense of contentment washing over him. He knows the road ahead will have its challenges, but for the first time in a long time, he feels equipped to meet them head on. With an open heart and an unwavering spirit, his journey of self-discovery marked by acceptance and transformation is far from over, but it has already brought him more joy and authenticity than he had ever imagined possible.